he pulled a cart so he used to being straight. Well, were they going to be so strong, the last thing I want him to do is lock up his body and be straight. I want to teach him how to bend. So when I teach him how to bend, if he bends, he relaxes. See how soft he gets when he just bends his body the least little bit? So I teach him that's what I want. Now, when I raise my hand up, it means don't go forward anymore. So when I come around with my hand up, I expect him to spin his butt around just like that. See how he's not pulling on my hand one? Now, if I send him forward, see, I can get that forward momentum. See how he doesn't want to get bent going forward, he doesn't know what to do. So I'll add a little bit more pressure. to say, oh, I'm going over here to Rice Street, but not go to care and have no empathy for what he feels like doing, as long as he tries to do what I ask. See, we don't want our animals to be bullies. And in order to do that, I have to be weak. If I can get that done calmly and teach him how to try, teach him to love me, you know, that I'm teaching something that's totally opposite of what he's built to do. He's built to lock up and pull a plow. Let's be real. So, in order for somebody that would want to ride him, you know, he's got to have some manners. He's got to be able to steer and be dependable. So the only way I know to do that is by building trust. But there are times when you have to say, okay, you're not trying, and step it up. So I'm going to jerk it a little harder, because if I make seem like any lift, now I'll stop and pet it. Okay? If I hit him a little harder, you know, that halter, it ain't going to hurt his head. Besides, it is. So, I want him to know that when I bump him over, I mean to bend and get soft and relax. See how he threw his head up? So I'm going to turn my head away, and I'm going to look at you and have tension, and I'm going to just keep holding my hand up here and moving it around until he quits. See that? I want him to know I'm never going to, unless he knocks my hat off my head, I have no reason to block or swat him upside the head. But so now, well, he tends to get nervous and lock up. Well, if we don't desensitize that, then it's not going to do any good, because every time he gets nervous, what's he going to do? He's going to lock up and go where he wants to go. So I have to add and imitate stressful situations in order to teach him how I want him to handle those situations. See there? He's always wanting to walk over there. Well, I don't care what's over there. I want him to stay with me and focus on me. See? I don't care what I do with this jacket, whether he's had it done before or not. So, I'm just going to rub it all over him. See? If he was upset, he would try to go somewhere and he'd try to kick at it. Handling it so well, we can drop the rope there and blindfold him. See, now he has to worry about his other senses. Okay, he's a little nervous. He's looking around and seeing good, so I'm going to take it off. Good. If I try it again, see how he's going to worry about it? Good. Test. If he's in the fourth grade, expect him to pass. Okay? So we got to evaluate him and see what's his weak points, what's his strong points, to know when to add or give back and take the pressure off. You know, we have to be partners. So now I'm going to work on teaching him to bend with the bit. Okay? I'll put his range up there just like I'm not. Now, remember, it's always easier for me to teach left and right than it is to go forward. Okay? We know when he goes forward, he locks up, he gets heavy, he doesn't listen. Okay? This makes it a lot wider. See how I can just bump with two fingers and get this big old mule to start moving around? Now I want him to move around quietly and smoothly. Okay? I'm going to raise this hand up. There. There. See, if I can't do it on the ground, I can't do it on his back. But see how my elbow's out? There. Now watch, I can also do this. Put my arm over his back. You say, hey, come on right here. Good boy. Now you say, hey, come around here. Good boy. Good boy. And hey, come around here. Good boy. See how I'm bumping so he can't latch onto me? Teaching him how to break up that resistance. Bump, bump, bump. Good boy. Very good. Now let's just see what he decides to do, which is not following me, which is okay. So I'm going to chase that butt away. Okay? When I chase that butt away, it forces him to look at me and acknowledge me as the leader. See how his nose follows me now? Because of the pressure I add. So, I'm not going to get upset when he doesn't do what I want. That tells me that I need to be a better teacher and teach him how I want his feet to move. He doesn't want to stand still, and I want him to stand still. The quickest way I'm going to get him to stand still is move his feet in a manner which I accept. Okay? Control the mind, you have the body. And remember, when my hand comes up, he's not supposed to go forward. See how he's sucking back every step? That's because my hand's up. So when I'm under, when he's got the saddle on, and I pick my hand up, I don't want him to think anything other than don't go forward or slow down or soften up. You know? So let's try it now. See how his nose followed me? Good boy. See, I'd rather wait until they can do it on their own. See how that's the ring that I did it for him? Very good. Now, every time he gets it right, he gets added on. Now, if you'll remember, you know, if you grew up back in the day, like me, older people didn't tell you when you got something right. They just reminded you when you got it wrong, and they really reminded you when you got it wrong. So, this way I'm being clear to the animal. Because a lot of times when we were kids and we do a good job, nobody told you you did a good job. It was just expected. Well, if that animal doesn't understand that, all it's thinking every time is, I don't know, you know, what's the point of doing this if I'm getting it wrong all the time? And it can be a simple, you know, misunderstanding of, how we may take somebody's tone or somebody's efforts compared to their words. Now the reason I'm putting my spurs on is because I want to teach him to be soft to a leg, okay? Because kicking him in the side and hurting him is basically like me kicking an armored car without steel-toed boots.
Thank you.
see how I can whip this around and I can keep them off of you? And he said, tie them all at the same time. See, that's not hurting him at all. But it's keeping him out of my bubble. Thank you.
Thank you.
See how when I asked him to stop, he stopped when he wanted to, not because he knew. See that? So I'm going to stay pulling until he releases pressure. To tell him, see now I bumped, and tell him to back off of that bit. He's not to lay on it like it's a table or a bed.
Nice.
just some things. That's the only way I know to teach to get them that way is repetition of what I learned. It's not necessarily fair, but one part about life is fair all the time. So try not to get too big of a fight. Try to have him be willing. So if I make things harder for him and I raise the bar of my expectations of just his try and willingness up to here, when he gets a rider that doesn't know as much as I do, he'll have that willingness and drive to please and make up for them instead of, oh, you didn't ask for the right thing, so now I'm going to try to buck you off or try to hurt you. You know, I want these animals to be confident with the people that get them and them to appreciate, you know, where they're at in their life and actually enjoy them. Same thing we want for ourselves. So, Keith wants to come over here, so I'm going to ask.